And good morning, people. Welcome back to Jade Cocoon 2. All that we've got left for the moment is going into the number 4's feature shut dungeon. And I'm starting out in Water Return, so we're going down to Water Return 4. But before we go there, let's give a little recap over what we've found in water, in the water forest. All started pretty benignly until we encountered a trap set by a beast hunter trying to catch Karma. And we were saved by this peculiar blue-skinned girl. As we moved on through the forest, we found out that this girl was Cure. And she had a dream, had a single wish. She wanted to be the same as everyone. She didn't want to be in this forest in that form. She wanted to be the same as everyone else. Everyone she's seen go past. And she knew there was one thing that could give her that wish. The orb. So she started her own journey down to it. As we went further, and got to know Cure a little bit better, and the fact that she saw us as the same as her, as we aren't exactly normal with our tail on the back there. A friendship brew. They hunted, they camped together, and they've made it down to this far. There's been other beast hunters as well going down. Some have been searching for us to defeat. Some have been going after Cure to capture. All have failed. There's just the one question now. Do we get the orb? Or does Cure get her wish? Because only one of those can actually happen. Water Return 4. Boss. Go ahead. So, the two monsters deep inside have been summoned by the orb to do battle on the enemy side. For us is Cure. In her dragon form, they did say she was a dragon. There she is. And on our side, we have Kalmakapu, or Kalmakahu, who is pretty much the incarnation of our darker side. Convenient timing. I now have a fully evolved, as much as I can, team. So there's my go jet. It's only a single beast we're facing, though. We're only fighting Cure in this form. It's pretty much akin to a boss fight. One of the previous boss fights. It's a stronger version of a fully evolved form. Has multiple different styles of attack. It's done Ramakite, so we already seen it does Earth. And there's a Wind. Unfortunately, there is really only one side that can win this, and to make this story progress, unfortunately, that needs to be us. Ramakite's upped its defense by quite a bit. Agnite, so gained a lot of skills, it seems. Defense is down now, so we can hit it for some amount of damage. And there's Ramakite again. So what I'm going to do is take this opportunity to re-up my Ramakite, re-up my SP and HP, and then attack it again. Strangely, we haven't seen it do any water moves for being in a water forest as yet. Yeah, it seems to be rotating Ramakite, Darkrai, and then Agnite. So this should be a Ramakite. No, there's Jagiluna. So it does have a water move. And it gained 15 health. Okay, I'm not too worried about that amount. And this fight is over. So 6,000 experience as well for that. But we've won, and we should get the orb. odd statement by Lafont there, I feel. And it's the Orb of Water. So we've got our first orb. So, next up, we're going to go and get the second one, because that's what we're doing at the moment. So I'm going to make my preparations, meet you down there, and, yeah, we'll go for whatever one I'm choosing next. See you in a moment. Next, we have Barren Earth, number 4, we're going to. The Earth Forest. In this one, we sort of got introduced to the idols of the temple, the Sweet Knights. They really didn't have a lot going for themselves at the time. Sure, they were popular. Sure, they were winners in the arena. But that was what the producer wanted. So he manipulated it. But he's looking for ratings. He's looking for a way to increase the gain that the Sweet Knights pull in. So he presented them with a task to beat Kahu to the orb. First up, we went against Choco. Get the name right, might help. The girl who likes battling with the divine beasts. Very adept to it as well. Then Cinnamon. Sorry. Not Cinnamon, then Vanilla stepped up, tried her luck at getting in our way. Was it the other way around? No, it was Vanilla first. The self-sacrifice bunt, as it was called, yeah. Someone who adores divine beasts. Sure, she has her favourites, but she adores divine beasts. And there's also Cinnamon, the cool, collected one. But each have sort of found their own path during this, in being a bit more independent. They're seeing things a bit more from being outside of what the group does. So, yeah, the group is sort of slowly spreading apart. And Kokona, the leader of the group, isn't sure what to do. She's never seen herself as a strong leader, especially now. She's seen what her faults are. She's seen herself as the one to keep them together, but she doesn't know how. She's the last hope for the Sweet Knights. If she loses, they get disbanded. Baron Earth 4. Go ahead. So at the end, everyone turns up for Kokona's battle. She knows she's not the strongest, but she's going to try anyway. She knows it's unlikely she's going to win, but she's going to give it her best shot for her team, for her friends. And unfortunately, we have to win. She does have a fairly okay team. It's mostly a lot of damage though. There's no real support as far as I'm aware. We've seen total loss, we've seen sold out. I believe this one is the tackle. Yeah, it's tackle. So a lot of defense. Sorry, a lot of physical attacks. And I've pretty much destroyed everything. Everything that she can really do. So, really, the only thing we can do is just finish this fight up. And done. Sorry, Kokona. Had to do it. We need that orb. 2,500 experience, not really that much as a reward. Although it levels up. So even Levant is a fan. And the Sweep Knights aren't getting disbanded. Well, they got disbanded but suddenly reformed again. And what did he mean by a new member? Anyways, that's the second orb. The Earth orb right here. No matter how you look at it, it's the orb of Earth. Next up, the third orb. So I'm gonna go and prepare, and I'll meet you there.